Hi friends, welcome to Jayaprakash Nagdevli Tips YouTube channel. Today, we have with us Mr. Chengalaraya. So I have requested him to speak about National Urban Livelihoods Mission. Mr. Chengalaraya, welcome to our show. Please enlighten us about this project.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Beautiful morning to everyone. Dear friend, I want to introduce myself. I am Chengalaraya, retired chief manager. Worked in State Bank of Mysore, retired in the year 2014, after serving 38 years of service in banking industry. Now I'm working as a treasurer in Indian Senior Chambers, Bangalore for the time being. First of all, I thank our mentor, eminent speaker, Sri Jayaprakash Nagdevli sir, for giving this opportunity to speak briefly about the National Urban Livelihoods Mission, that is called as NULM. Friends, I want to tell you something about this. First of all, I want to tell you about what is NULM, when it was launched, what is its aim, what is its mission, guiding principles, values, and strategy to remove the poverty. Now, let us understand what is NULM. It means National Urban Livelihoods Mission. It was launched in the year 2011 by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Aims to reduce poverty and vulnerability of the urban poor livelihoods by enabling them to access gainful self-employment and skilled wage employment. It also facilitates access to suitable space, institutional credit, social security, and skills to the urban street vendors for accessing marketing opportunities. I want to say one beautiful word by Charles Darwin. He has said, if the misery of the poor be caused not by the loss of the nature, but by our institutions, great is ours. That is the one. And friends, I want to tell you about the categorization of the urban poverty. The next question is, about 25% population of India are in urban poverty, consisting of about 81 million people. And it can be categorized into three groups. Number one is residual vulnerability. That is, we have no space, no shelter, no housing. Number two is social vulnerability. That is, low voice in government, no safety and security. Number three is occupational vulnerability. That is lack of job security, poor working conditions, unemployment. All these here are categorized under the urban poverty. Then who are the urban people? I want to tell you about that. The urban people are commonly women, children, and aged people, SCSTs, minorities, unemployed, differently abled persons, that is low priority. Not disabled, this is differently aged people, low priority people, urban street vendors, slum dwellers, homeless, rag pickers, and so on. And what are the reasons for urban poverty? The very next question is. The reasons are so many, I will tell you in a brief. This is because of low level of education, number one, constant threat of eviction, removal, confiscation of goods, a non-existence of social security, lack of sanitary living conditions, discrimination, social exclusion, crime and violence, insecurity, tenure, hazardous environmental conditions, lack of voice in government. These are the reasons for the urban poor. Now I am coming to the very, very important question is, now we know what is the LUM, what is its aims, what is mission, etc. Now we'll come to the important strategy, how to eradicate urban poverty. The important things are implementing of poverty alleviation programs. I will tell you the programs afterwards. Enhancing and expanding existing livelihood option of the poor, urban poor. Building skills to motivate the urban poor to form their own institutions, such as access to finance. Expanding their skills. Number third is enterprises and assets. Then providing training and support to the micro enterprises. Micro enterprises, small industries, small scale industries. Then very important thing is providing basic infrastructure, such as the infrastructure is not at all there, the urban lives. Water supply is required, sanitation, safety and security, catering to the needs of dependent children, aged, disabled, mentally ill, recovering patients, and so on. These are the category. We have to provide all the basic infrastructure to these people. Then, right of the urban people homeless to what are the urban people's rights are there? Their right to have food, health care, and social admission, affordable housing. All these are very much required. And PDS, Public Distribution Scheme, ICDS, and feeding program, financial inclusion, social admission, affordable housing. PDS means Public Distribution Scheme. Then ICDS means Integrated Child Development Services. According to the Constitution 74th of Amendment Act 1992, it emphasizes legitimate functioning of urban local body, that is called ULB, in a phased manner to provide what is required, shelter, social housing, and social protection. Now, on 1st December 1997, the SJSRY scheme was introduced. SJSRY means Swarna Jayanti Shahari Rojgar Yojana. Then on 23rd September 2013, it was restructured as Deenadayalan Antodaya Yojana, that is DLULM. And there are two phases in that. The phase one was 2013 to 2017, and the phase two was 2017 to 2022. And the coverage area is all the district headquarters and cities with population of 1 lakh and more. These are the coverage area. Then what is the importance of doing this and what is the assistance coming from the government? I will tell you one by one. Full funds from government towards construction shelters, urban homeless from 2019 wards. Full funds for housing. Then employment policy funding. They will give about center by 75% and 25% state percent. Then interest subvention on bank loans, interest subsidy, that is 5% to 7% for micro enterprises. And loans amount from 2 lakhs to 10 lakhs. Then formation of SSG groups. SSG means self-help groups. And they will give about ₹10,000 is given for training and hand-holding each group, formation of SSGs. Then self-employment and self-employment, institutional credits such as SBF. SBF means small business finance, and MSE units, micro units. And formation of SEP, CBDT, EST, and P. SEP means self-employment program, capacity building and training, employment through skills, training and placement, and so on, such as schemes. And now the Pradhan Mantri Dhan Yojana has come, PMJDY. And another is Sumukhya Samyojani Yojana, Rashtriya Samstya Bhima Yojana. All these schemes are now introduced by the government. What is that PMDY? I will tell you in a brief. About 29.43 crore of accounts has been opened with a balance of 65,532 crores. About 25 crore Jantar accounts have been opened in our country, having 5.82 crores with balance, zero balance. Without balance, they have opened 5.8 crore people. And here the provision is the accident insurance has covered for 1 lakh and they are going to give you about 4% rate of interest. Then coming to SSEM, it was introduced in 2015. The aim of the scheme is to meet education and marriage of expenses of a girl child, that relates to the girl child. Then coming to PMJ Jyoti Bhima Yojana, insurance cover is there up to 2 lakhs on their death, and it is covered for 18 years to 50 years. Then coming to the RSBY, health insurance cover to unorganized sectors is there, that is construction workers, street vendors, and porters, mine workers, covers up to 30,000 for family. That is the Bhima Yojana is there, Rashtriya Swastha Bhima Yojana. Then coming to PMMY, Mudra Yojana, that for Shishu, they will give a loan of ₹5,000. For Kishore, they will give 5 lakhs. But Tarun, they will give about 10 lakhs. Thus, Micro Units Development and Refinance Agency Limited 2016. But when the situation was improving, the GDP was growing, the per capita income of the urban people was also growing. Suddenly, because of the pandemic, COVID-19 invaded India in March 2020. However, things will again improve. We should be optimistic, be positive, and hope for the best. Thank you, sir, for giving the opportunity.
Mr. Chengalraya, you have enlightened us and as well as our subscribers about the very important scheme of the central government, National Urban Livelihood Mission. Thank you very much. Friends, if you like this video, please do like and comment. And if you have any questions, you can just write your questions and please share this video at least to 5 people. Okay, thank you very much.